diamonds need to be cut in very, very specific parameters to get it to maximize light return.
This is the round brilliant cut, one of the most popular shapes in the world.
When a diamond is proportioned in a perfect way, it will act as a hall of mirrors. If it's not, then the light will push out of the back and you'll basically lose light.
In 1919, a Belgian mathematician named Marcel Tolkowski used principles of optical physics and math to determine the optimum number and angle of facets to create a diamond that perfectly caught the light.
When he came along, it was more putting a science to the actual proportions and understanding that they matter.
Imagine this is an uncut crystal with a smooth surface on it. And now we're going to shine green light onto it.
Deborah Berebichez, a physicist, explains how light can be captured in a crystal by using a green laser so our camera can see it.
So we see that spot on the wall because most of the light is getting transmitted to the other side. Now, if instead we use a faceted crystal, we can see how most of the light is getting trapped and bouncing around inside the crystal. And a lot of it is coming back reflected into our eyes, very much like a hall of mirrors.
Tolkowski found that a diamond cut with nearly 60 carefully angled facets created an exquisite geometry that reflected light around the stone many times, then bounced it out through the top and into our eyes. We call this phenomenon brilliance. When white light enters a diamond at just the right angle, something extraordinary happens. These facets, along with how the diamond affects wavelengths of light, disperse it into a rainbow of colors, like light through a prism. This creates the flashes of color called fire.
Because of diamond's hardness, the polishing of the facets creates such incredible mirrors that the diamond bounces the light back to the eye. So you're really getting a combination of light to give this beautiful dispersion and sparkle.